If I could carry a tune, I would sing of this day. What we are about to accomplish, the galaxy will forever behold with great wonderment. But perhaps I'm getting ahead of myself. After all, we've never properly met.
Darth Arcus.
Yes, a pleasure. In my capacity as Minister of Military Offense, I have repeatedly enjoyed the fruits of your labor. And this is my most trusted advisor, Lana Benico.
Secrets. They are windows, doors, and walls all at once. You lead a complicated life.
I'm open to sharing more of myself if you are.
I might be persuaded. A discussion for another time.
You came. Good. I'm aware I've been somewhat quiet following your success on Tython. Don't mistake my reticence for apathy. Truth is, I have a great deal to say. Now that we're alone, we can have a real dialogue.
Why don't you start by telling me a little bit more about yourself?
Oh. What is it you want to know?
You are unusual for a Sith. You don't even have a title.
Knowledge, answers, truth, the Force. These are the things I hold dear. Titles don't interest me.
What wouldn't I want to know? You fascinate me.
Considering the places you've gone, all you must have seen, I'm flattered that you would feel that way. Can we... Sorry, I don't mean to appear antisocial, but I do have pressing concerns. Darth Arcus wasn't entirely forthcoming about his reasons for invading the Jedi Temple. Not even with me. He was after a very specific item. An artifact.
I overheard Arcus talking to Go. It did seem like they had some ulterior motive.
If I knew more, I could determine what that motive is. But there's very good reason to be concerned about it.
Meaning?
I now believe that the Republic's attack on Korriban wasn't a retaliation for Tython. It was intended to coincide with our own attack.
Attacking Korriban while the Empire still held the Jedi Temple didn't make much sense to me at the time. It still doesn't.
Nor should it, not from our current vantage point. But a wider context may exist that could explain recent events. There's something in the Force that I've never felt before. It exists nowhere and everywhere at once, writhing, growing.
That sounds ominous.
I think I sense this growth because I'm tied to it somehow. Maybe by association to Darth Arcus. I think the Empire's in terrible danger. Someone like you, Commander. Most would never trust you, but you're practically the only one I trust right now. Help me unravel this mystery.
Can't think of anyone else I'd rather do some unraveling with.
Is that right? Well, I'm afraid there's nothing for us to act on just yet. I'll keep my eyes and ears open. You do the same. I have to be at Arcus's side now, but I'll remain in touch. I promise. Welcome. So good to see you again. As implied in our last brief communication, Darth Arcus is at the center of a grand conspiracy. Arcus had the Jedi Temple raided to acquire knowledge of Rakata technology that he could use to harm the Empire. Even now, he plots against us.
A secret conspiracy? I have some measure of expertise in that area.
Yes, Commander. A blessing you are here. I'll admit I'm a bit out of my depth.
I know Arcus was a mentor to you. This can't be easy to take.
He had me fooled for some time, but I see his true face now. I followed Arcus to a secure undersea laboratory here on Manan, where he's working with a Selkath geneticist on something. I've been trying to learn more. I've also discovered that Colonel Darrock secured passage to the same laboratory. He was behind the Republic's raid on Korriban.
It seems to me that Arcus and Darrock are working together.
That's my feeling as well, but we won't know for certain unless we get into that laboratory. As I said, it's a well-protected facility. You'll have to make your way through heavily armed Selkath and dismantle their security grid.
You're not coming?
I'd intended to confront Darth Arcus myself, but I sense a presence here. A potential ally. I'll remain in touch and let you know how my search progresses. May the Force be at your service.
I've met our potential ally, who's already proved quite resourceful. He's learned of a prisoner in the security hub who's been scheduled for disposal by experimentation. This Jakaro sounds like someone you might want to talk with, as soon as you contend with the head of security.
Don't know me, but I'm here with Lana. She's meditating using her connection to Darth Arcus to pinpoint his location. She wanted you to know if I found anything, and I did. Energy readings from Garima's lab. Rakata technology's firing up like crazy in there. Don't know for sure what's going on, but I can pretty much guarantee it's got to be stopped. Getting readings from their Alpha Cyborg. That thing's serious, and it's coming right for you. Stay sharp!
Hang on. Emergency pod's almost secure, but not quite.
You're with the Republic, aren't you?
That's right. I'm also saving your lives. You got a problem with that?
Just get us out of here.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to do.
Hurry! I wasn't built to survive the crushing depths!
Okay, all set. Climb in and enjoy the ride.
Welcome back. Once again, you've displayed a skill and determination that few possess.
I've seen worse.
Perhaps I should make proper introductions.
No need to tell me who I'm addressing. I'm Theron Shan, Republic SAS, and your new ally.
You could always join the Empire. I think you'd make a welcome asset.
I'm oddly flattered. Not even going to consider it, of course, but flattered.
The way we were fooled by Darth Arcus, the same happened to Theron, except with the Colonel.
And between what you found down in that lab and what Lana and I pieced together, I can tell you they're both traitors.
Arcus and Darrock are in league with a dangerous movement, a shadowy cult known as the Order of Revan.
Every indication is that Revan died. Surely he's not in control of the order that bears his name.
It's not Revan himself, but those who follow his doctrine we're concerned with. They seem to have grown rather bold. The Order of Revan used to operate in the shadows of Imperial space, but now their ranks include at least one major Republic figure.
That means I can't trust my people and Lana can't trust hers. Present company excluded. And if the Revanites are building an army of cyborgs...
This is Jakaro.
And I am C2D4, former translator to Her Eminence Queen Lena of Onderon.
Hey, Jakaro, how would you feel about helping me track those two down? We'll talk about it. Lana, will you be joining us?
We don't yet know how deep the Revanites' influence runs. I must learn what I can from within the Empire.
Thank you.
You've done well here, as expected. We'll speak again soon. Our work here is done.
I was about to send out a search party.
Sorry, I had to confirm some things before coming to see you. As I suspected, the Order of Revan as it once existed is no more. A bit of a shame, really. The Revanites' pragmatism may have been anathema to the Sith, but there was something appealing about it.
I'd much rather do without mysterious enclaves and secret orders, thank you.
They're good for job security, if nothing else. But if they get their way, you won't have a job. The Order of Revan, as it stands now, doesn't wish to change the Empire from within. It aims to destroy us completely, and the Republic along with us. I've not yet learned why or how, but Theron Shan might. He appears to be rather good at his job.
You're on the verge of giving me a complex. Are you suggesting Shan's better than me?
I would never dream of it, Commander. I only mean to say that he'll make a fine ally.
Good at his job or not, he's not bad to look at.
Yes, he does have a certain way about him. Was there anything else you wanted to discuss?
That time we spoke after reclaiming Korriban, I thought we shared something. A connection. Was I wrong?
After what you just said about Theron Shan, I thought maybe you'd moved on. But no, you aren't wrong.
You also admitted an attraction to him.
I suspected you might be trying to tweak me. I suppose I tweaked back. No hard feelings, I hope. I have to go now. There's much yet to uncover about the Revanites' plans and the formation of this infinite army of theirs. I'll be thinking of you. Glad to see you again, as always. But I'm afraid any further niceties will have to wait. I know I've mentioned before a strange disturbance within the Force. A sort of writhing mass tied to Darth Arcus. I thought I'd use my connection to Arcus to seek out others tied to the disturbance. Revanites working against us from within. I found a few.
Did you learn anything?
Theron Shan helped me decipher coded messages between the Revanites. Due to interference on Manan, they've accelerated their schedule.
Theron Shan, you couldn't have brought this to my attention instead.
I would have thought it beneath your prestige. Anyway, Theron happened to contact me, so I made use of him.
What did he want?
Theron's tracked Arcus and Colonel Darok to a base on Rakata Prime. They're building their infinite army. And there's more. The implants they're using, they're made from pieces of the Starforge.
The Starforge? Tell me what you know about it.
The Starforge was a Force-imbued, self-sustaining shipyard, Rakatan. It was destroyed centuries ago, but the Revanites have recovered some of the wreckage. Its technology makes the soldiers nearly immortal, seizes their minds as well, placing them under the Revanites' full control.
I've had enough of Arcus thinking he can play me for a fool. Ready a shuttle to Rakata Prime. We're going.
I have a shuttle waiting, Commander. Theron and Jakara are waiting for us planetside. The sooner we depart for Rakata Prime, the better.
Jakara, D4.
Jakara, spare at least a modicum of respect.
Hey, we're set to move on the Temple of the Ancients when you are.
That's the traitor's base of operations.
Yeah, the Rakata designed the Star Forge in that temple thousands of years ago. Now it's Arcus and Derek's grunt factory.
Theron and I will be monitoring your progress from Jakara's ship. We'll assist you as we can, keep you apprised of matters.
Your what? Jakara, I agree to no such thing. Wait, was this the talk with Agent Shan you powered me down for?
I should warn you, it's a rough road to the temple. The area's lousy with tribal Rakatans, more than happy to fight. Found that out the hard way.
Wonderful! We're all going to die! Wonderful!
Remain focused and all will be well. I'm sure of it. We'll be in touch soon.
That's it. We're in. Theron?
Okay. According to the structural plans, the only way to get at the head Revanites is through that conscription center.
The cyborgs are dormant for now, but they're set to go on high alert once they detect you. A console overload will fry them from the inside. Nope. Can't work the power safeties from here. You'll have to do the honors.
A sound plan. Theron, why can't I get this sensor to work?
Because Jacaro isn't a big fan of upkeep. Probably a dead relay. I'll check it out.
Now that he's gone, might I recommend not doing as Theron suggests?
An overload would destroy the data as well. The Empire might want its own infinite army someday. You would have to fight those cyborgs, but...
They're aberrations. I'm setting the console to overload.
I see.
Don't like my decision. Tough.
Hey, there you go. Nice work. For, you know, being Imperial and all.
Room's clear of vital signs. You're all set.
If you say so. Hey, those sensor relays were fine, by the way. Not sure what the problem is.
Was. The sensor appears to be working again.
As important as Arcus and Derek were to the cause, their deaths won't stop us. They will even slow us down.
That voice. I've heard it before.
It's Revan.
I almost had the infinite army I wanted so badly. But even without them, I have enough.
You seem rather alive for someone who's supposed to be a corpse.
Oh, I was dead. For all of a blink. I've been reborn. My mind is clearer, my power intensified, and now, with the order under my command, I'm unstoppable.
You're telling me the Revanites weren't always under your control?
At first, I wanted nothing to do with them. I was no prophet. Then I saw them in a new light. A secret group of devotees waiting to follow my lead without question, to help me save the galaxy. I was a fool to ever disregard them. I finally let the Revanites into my world. A world you have to be erased from.
Turbo lasers are locking on! Get out of there!
You made it.
The way Revan was laying waste to that place, I wasn't sure you'd come out of it in one piece.
What are you talking about? I'm hardly in one piece.
Anyway, my point is, I'm glad you got out of there. Any ally right now is a welcome ally.
So coy. I think someone in the SIS has a crush on me.
What, me? Into you? That's so... You know, don't be ridiculous.
If I may say, Agent Sean, you appear to be rather flush all of a sudden.
We're gonna... Jacaro and I and the droid, we're leaving now so you can have your... official Imperial debrief or... whatever. Lana, when you're done, we can start picking out backwaters to go lie low in.
If we'd at least recovered the conscription protocols for the Infinite Army, this might feel more like a victory. Not that we have anyone in the Empire to trust right now. The Revanites have just proven they're everywhere. Jakaro's had 12 death sentences declared on him. Theron's been disavowed by the SIS. And the Empire's placed a bounty on my head for the murder of Darth Arcus.
I'll go to Darth Maar himself and make sure this asinine charge goes away.
Please, Commander, speak to no one, not even Darth Maar. Our names can't be cleared unless we expose the Revanites. And we can't expose the Revanites without knowing who to expose. The way forward is clear. Theron, Jacaro, and I are going underground. We'll find a way to uncover Revan's plan and stop him.
You can't do it alone. You'll need me alongside you.
For all intents and purposes, you are Imperial Intelligence. The Empire needs you. Be who you are, but be observant and tell no one the truth about us or what you know. Above all, do not try to contact me.
I wish you didn't have to go.
It won't be easy for me either. Just know that I'll be thinking of you. All our fates ultimately rest in your hands. Remember that.